Good morning, students. So today we are going. Welcome back to your chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss about the molecular mass and formula unit mass. Till the last class, we discussed the symbol of elements. What is a molecule, atoms, and everything we discussed. Basic things we discussed. Today we are going to discuss about the molecular mass and formula unit mass. Molecular mass and formula unit mass. Formula unit mass. Formula unit mass. So we all know about the molecule. What is molecule? Now today we are going to discuss about the mass of that particular molecule. So certainly molecular mass can be defined as it is the sum of atomic masses of all elements present in a particular molecule. When you consider a molecule, let's take a simple example, water, H2O, water molecule. So this is a molecule. Now we are going to find out the molecular mass of this particular molecule, that is the molecular mass of water. How to find out this one? This is found out by adding the atomic masses of the elements present in that particular molecule. That means we can define the molecular mass as the sum of atomic masses of all elements present in that particular molecule. So here H2O is there. The constituent elements are hydrogen and oxygen is there. So if you know the atomic masses of hydrogen and oxygen, we can easily find out the molecular mass of water. Last classes we already discussed about the atomic masses of certain elements, and based on that let's find out its molecular mass. How many atoms are there? Hydrogen, 2 atoms are there. So let's say 2 into, what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? It is of course 1. So 1, 2 into 1 means here the number of atoms present in that particular molecule and should be get multiplied with the atomic masses of that particular element. Here H2O is there. 2 hydrogen atoms are there. So we just write here 2 and its atomic mass is 1. So get multiplied with the 1. And then plus, so as I told you, molecular mass is the sum of atomic masses of all elements present in that particular molecule. So based on that fact, and already we entered the atomic masses of hydrogen with respect to its number, then next one to oxygen. So oxygen only 1 is there, 1 atom is there, no 2 or 3 are not here, so only 1 here, and its atomic mass is 16. So 2 into 1 plus 1 into 16. So how it came? 2 plus 16. So answer is 88. Unified atomic mass or unified molecular mass. So this is the way to find out the molecular mass of a particular molecule. How to find out? By taking the sum of atomic masses of constituent element present in that particular molecule. This is known as molecular mass. And let's take another case. HCl, hydrochloric acid, HCl. So how to find out the molecular mass of the HCl? Let's take the atomic masses of hydrogen plus atomic masses of chlorine. Atomic mass of chlorine. Hydrogen atomic mass is 1 plus chlorine atomic mass is 35.5. So its atomic mass is 36.5. And when you consider, so this is the case for the molecular mass of these two elements. Now let's take the molecular mass of another molecule that is in your textbook HNO3 had given. HNO3, nitric acid. It is nitric acid, HNO3. HNO3, it is nitric acid. So now we are going to find out the molecular mass of nitric acid. How to find out? The same way as we discussed That is by taking the sum of atomic masses of element present in that particular molecule. So here, what are the atoms? Hydrogen is present, nitrogen is present, oxygen is present. Hydrogen and nitrogen each have only one atom is present, but when you take the oxygen, three atoms are present there. So by considering its atomic mass, how to find out like this? One. How many atoms? Only one atoms. And what is the atomic mass? One itself. One into one. Understood all of you? Plus, how many nitrogen atoms are there? One. So one into, what is its atomic mass? 14. 1, 4. 14. Okay, then one more atom is also there. How many are there? 3. So 3 into 16. 3 into 16. So 1 into 1 plus 14 plus 16 into 3. 28. Isn't it? 28. No? 16 into 3, what it is? 48. So then the total is 63 unit, that is 63 unified mass. So this is a way to find out the molecular mass. Do you understand what it is? It is a sum of atomic masses of different elements present in that particular molecule. It is known as a molecular mass. Then we move on to the formula unit mass. Formula unit mass is the same as that of the molecular mass. Formula unit mass is the sum of atomic masses of elements present in the formula of a molecule. If you consider a molecule and the formula, if you are able to write the formula of that particular molecule, then just take the sum of the atomic masses of element present in that formula. So the same as a molecular mass of formula unit mass is the sum of atomic masses of elements present in a formula. With the difference from this molecular mass is that why you find out of this formula unit mass is mainly important or which is significant in the case of a molecule having charged species. This is the case. So when you consider NaCl, sodium chloride, NaCl, sodium chloride. In this particular molecule, in this particular compound, sodium will be exist as positively charged cation and chlorine will be exist as negatively charged anion. അതായത് നമ്മൾ എൻ എ സി എൽ എടുക്കുമ്പോൾ അത് എൻ എ സി എൽ നമ്മൾ പറയുമെങ്കിലും ആക്ച്വലി അത് എക്സിസ്റ്റ് ആകുന്നത് എങ്ങനെയാണ്? ചാർജ് ബെയറിംഗ് ആയിട്ടായിരിക്കും അത് എക്സിസ്റ്റ് ആകുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ വെൻ യു കൺസിഡർ ദ ഫോർമുല യൂണിറ്റ് മാസ് ദ സെയിം വേ ആസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ മോളിക്യുലർ മാസ്. സോഡിയം ഇറ്റ്സ് അറ്റോമിക് മാസ് ഈസ് 20 പ്ലസ് ക്ലോറിൻ ഇറ്റ്സ് അറ്റോമിക് മാസ് ഈസ് 35.5. സോ ദ ആൻസർ ഈസ് 58.5 unit. എന്താണ്, what is the difference between molecular mass and formula unit mass? Both have to find out, both the way to find out both will be same. With the difference is that formula unit mass or formula mass is a significant only in the case of a compound having charged species. Charged species ഉള്ള compounds ലാണ് എന്ത് significant formula unit mass will be significant. Okay, so this is about the molecular mass and the formula unit mass. Then next we are moving to the next section of this chapter. Very very important section of this chapter, mole concept. Mole concept. Mole concept. This is a very very important topic, and this is many times repeated in your plus one, plus two, all the classes. So what do you mean by mole concept? Mole concept, it is actually the concept that is given to you about mole. Mole എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു കോൺസെപ്റ്റിനെ പറ്റി തരുന്ന ഒരു തിയറി അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു പാർട്ടാണ് mole concept. So normally when you consider an atom or a molecule, they are represented, their quantity should be represented by means of gram. gram or unified mass, atomic mass, etc. In the same way, the quantity of something could be expressed by means of another quantity called mole. Another quantity called mole. That is the first thing you have to understand. When you consider an element or when you consider a molecule, and normally it should be represented by means of a gram or etc. unified mass, atomic mass unit, etc. The same way, such type elements or this molecule could be represented by means of another quantity, we can call it as a mole. So, how can you define about the mole? How can you define about the mole? Mole means can be defined as one mole is an any species that quantity contains an atom or a molecule which is equal to its atomic mass or molecular mass. It's known as a one mole. So one mole of an any species is that quantity which contain having the mass equal to its atomic or molecular mass is known as one mole. So when you consider any element, if its atomic mass is given, which contain one mole, the quantity in terms of mole is one mole itself. When you consider water molecule H2O, when you consider water molecule H2O, what its molecular mass? It's 18. Okay, it's 18. So 18 means actually its molecular mass. This 18 gram of water molecule contains quantity, water quantity in by means of mole concept, it should be one mole. It should be one mole. So whatever you prefer, it's an atom or molecule, whatever it is, one mole of that species will be the number of atoms present in the present in its atomic or molecule. Okay, so this is about one mole. One mole can be defined as a one mole of any species is that quantity in number having mass equal to its atomic or molecular mass. Once more, one mole can be defined as a one mole is in any species is that quantity containing the number which is equal to its atomic or molecular mass. This is about the one mole. And if you consider one mole, whatever it is, it may be water molecule, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid, whatever be the molecule, one mole of any molecule, if we have, suppose, nammal oru molecule aanu engile, nammalila one mole unde engile, aa nammalilulla number of atoms, illengi number of molecules, illengi number of ions is given by a particular number, which is given as 6.023 × 10⁻³. This is very important. One mole of any substance, any molecule containing 6.023 × 10⁻³, which is known as a Avogadro's number. So the one to find out this is Avogadro, so that's why it is known as Avogadro's number. So Avogadro's number means what it is? It is the number of atoms, ions or molecule present in one mole of any substance. Aare eduthalum, water edukkam, HCl edukkam, nitric acid edukkam, endu venamengilum eduthalum, if that compound or that molecule is one mole, which containing the number of atom is 6.023 × 10⁻³. It's a fixed value, which was found out through a lot of experiment. So they fixed that the number of atoms present in one mole of any substance will be fixed, which is given as 6.023 × 10⁻². Is very, very important. So mole concept is a very important topic for you. So have to study. And one mole can be defined as an any species is that quantity containing the number having mass equal to its atomic or molecular mass. One mole of any substance contains a 6.023 × 10⁻². Number of particles. A particles and the atom are ions are the molecules. Okay, so this is the basic thing we have to understand under the heading mole concept. Then two more equations will be there. I will write that equation also. relating or based on that equation we have to do the problems. Very next class. Okay, thank you.